Alrighty guys, welcome to this another part of the tutorial series on the Zeebo Boeing 737-8. We are climbing our star from Amsterdam now, passing 8,000 feet onto to Golf. Let me have a look. To Romeo, check. And we are passing 10,000 feet now. At 10,000 feet you can turn off the landing lights and the runway turn off lights can come off. We'll check the flaps all up, and yeah, we're actually ready now, passing 10,000 feet. Aircraft is going to accelerate to 300 knots now, and we can enjoy a little bit of views. See you guys in a second, and I forgot to put the auto brake to the off position. Alrighty, see you guys in a second.
We lose ourselves in the spirit of things. We lose our sight when we put our trust in things of this material world, of things that fade away. Yet we keep coming back, 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 keep coming back.
Top of descent, and we are now descending flight level 150. You always reset the altitude on before top of descent, because then the aircraft gets its vertical navigation path, so it stays on the path. So, and then we are going to set the auto brake to 2, if it's a short runway 3 or max, and you look at the AVITAP, you fill in your arrival airport and you look at the runway you want to land. So for me it's 23 left, and you look at the frequency for the ILS and the course of the ILS. So for now I just set the course to 231, as you can see over here. You need to set it on both sides always, because always otherwise it's not able to fully capture, and you need to put the frequency, so 109.9, on here on the nav tab. So here active is 109.9, same goes for this side. So the aircraft is able to capture the localizer only if you filled in these two boxes of the runway, and this depends on your airport. So for me it's now 109.9, but if I would land on runway 5 right, it would be 110.15. So it depends on the airport, and you need to look at the AVITAP on which runway and which airport you're landing, and then put on the right frequency and the right course in on both sides, and then it should be good. And if in a second we should capture the localizer and glide slope of runway 23 left. So as you can see, we are now descending flight level 120, descending. I just put on 7000 feet. You can turn it down. I would always do half of it of what you're flying. So if you're flying the flight level 190, I would put 8000 feet. I just put 7000, but always do half. And if it the aircraft reaches 7000, well, yeah, it's, if it reaches 7000 feet, I'm going to turn it back to 3500 feet. So, okay, the plane is now decelerating, which we saw on the map. It was a deceleration point. Again, here's another deceleration point. We now decelerating to 240, which means the aircraft is going to fly slower in order to make this turn and to make the approach. We also can put the gear to the off position. We could have also done it a little bit earlier. It doesn't matter when you do it or if you do it. Well, if you just have it on up, the hydraulics just stay on, and otherwise now the hydraulics are off, so it's a little bit better for the plane to put it on off. But if we forget it, it's no problem. I also forget it in this short flight, because well, it's so short flight, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
Okay, we are now inbound Agueda in 4 nautical miles, and as soon as we hit 10,000 feet, we're going to turn on the landing lights again and put the engine start switches to continuous. Normally you do this at, well, 5,000, 7,000 feet, doesn't really matter. I always do it at 10, just to be sure, do not forget it, because on the approach, most of the time, you forget it because of all the things you're doing at the same time. And as you can see, the airplane is a little bit below our speed we need to fly. So if it's correctly, it's going to say FMC speed in a second, and it's going to give a little bit more throttle, or it's going to descend faster. Okay, 1000 feet, and we can turn on the landing lights and the engine start switch to continuous, which is one click to the right. Okay, we're now inbound Düsseldorf, and everything is set for the approach, and we'll see you in a few seconds. Alrighty, turning Xamot now, and inbound for our deceleration point, in which we are going to decelerate even more, and 8000 feet now. Everything is still set for landing, so for landing always make sure you put in the white course, the right frequencies for the ILS, and put these to continuous landing lights on, and then you should be good to go. You can also go back and have, if you have charge, you can look at the charge in the AVITAP. But it's not necessary at the moment. So I'm also in the last moment, I'm checking it via plan again. So we're inbound Bottrop now, which is Bravo Oscar Tango. And as you can see, the localizer, which is the horizontal path we are going to fly in a second, is armed again. And the glide slope, which is the vertical path we are going to fly in a second, is also now captured in these little boxes. So the aircraft is actually telling you it is able to fly these both things, and if you just put in one courses, it is not going to show this. Right, maybe it's going to show it, but not in the way you want it to show, because what we're going to do in a second is, when we are over here on this line, we are able to capture the ILS, which is an antenna next to the runway, which makes sure you are like a glider into the runway. So you follow your vertical path to the runway, which is this one, and you follow a horizontal path to the runway, which is this one. because LNAV and VNAV are not, well, they do work. You can see at the INAV approaches, but they are not, well, you don't use it because they are not that that good to use to fly into a runway, because the VNAV is going to fly with a vertical speed of about, well, 500,000 feet right into the runway, which means you will be gliding, not gliding, but you will be like diving into the runway, and you will eventually crash, of course. So this is what the ILS is for, and with the ILS you can also make an auto land, which I'm going to show you in a second on how to do an auto land in the Zeebo 3737 if necessary, because if there's really bad weather and you are not able to make a landing yourself, you can do an auto land. And this is a very easy procedure, but you need to know how to do it. So that's what I'm going to show you in a second. And as we can see, we are approaching Düsseldorf Airport, which is located over there, and we are now inbound for our ILS. So see you in a second.
Germany, Calver CEO representing Krefeld City. I do this for my people, try to do good. They don't care about us, although they actually should. While these rappers talk.
Alrighty, we are now inbound Matma, in which we are going to capture the ILS in a second. And we are a little bit too high, so that's what I fixed. So we can arm approach mode, and you can see glide slope and the localizer is armed, so you can see the localizer is captured to 3 left, which will be this runway. VOR log means the localizer, it's also gone to single channel, and the glide slope, as you can see, we are a little bit too high, but it's going to capture it in a second. This is also the vertical path, by the way. You can see if you're too high or too low, so now we are a little bit too high, but should fix itself in a second. So we can go flaps 2 and flaps 5, because we need to descend quite a bit. The altitude is required, but I want to be on the localizer again, so let's go to level change. QNH can go off to standard, so let's go to Actipascore again. Same goes for this one. 2500 is checked, and they should get our local, a glide slope now in a second. It's a little bit steep dive. Yeah, glide slope is captured too, so we can go and engage the second autopilot, which is necessary to make an auto land. And we can do gear down and flaps 15, and we can put our speed a little bit back to 180 on the glide slope until 4 DME. You can see the DME over here, and almost at 4.8 DME now. So we are going to reduce to 160. Flaps 25 is just the aircraft has gone over to land 3, which is the outer land mode. And flare and rollout are armed, so it should do everything itself. Let's have a look. Let's do a flaps 30 land. Can fill in these speeds over here, and it comes with a reference speed. So let's go back to reference speed now, which is flaps 30 and 130 for now. And the airplane should do everything itself with an auto land. So if you can see anything, it should make itself an auto land. We can put the speed brakes up again. I'm them. You do a little click up, and you can a little click up, and you can see the speed brake is armed. already, and now it's just waiting, and if there's anything going wrong, you just quickly disable the autopilot and take manual control. But for now, everything looks like it is going like plan. As you can see, the aircraft is flying itself. I'm not doing anything. So if you need to make an auto land anywhere in the world when there's no visibility, click both autopilots on, and it should make an auto land itself, which it is doing right now. And now you need to concentrate, because this is where it should flare, like it's doing right now. And alright, rollout, checked. And this is where you take manually control again, with your rudder pedals, or with your yaw. And you stow those reverses, 80 knots, checked. And you can disable the auto or anti-skid, the auto brakes, because we need to vacate right now. So make sure you on that sim you vacate fast. Coming up in the next tutorial, but just telling you a little tip at the moment. Alright, we are going to vacate left here, and when you vacate, you can put the flaps up again, all the way to the up position. You can put the runway turnoff and taxi lights on. All the landing lights can come up like this. These ones can go to auto again. You can put the strobe lights off, and you're going to start the APU, because we need power at the gate when we shut down our engines. And for now, we are ready to taxi to our gate, so see you in a second. Alright, and then it's just a simple easy taxi to the gate, which I'm doing right now. You can, well, if you're flying solo, you can take whatever gate you want. Doesn't really matter. You can see the APU has started, so here we're going on the APU buses. And the APU bleed, you can turn over here, on over here, and you can turn off the engine bleeds. Approaching the gate, you can turn off the runway turner from taxi lights, so that if there's a marshal, he's not going to be blinded from your lights. And then we are going to roll into the gate like this, and then we are going to shut down the aircraft. Hey, yeah. Alright, welcome to Düsseldorf. We taxi to the gate, and we are now going to shut down the aircraft, in which we are going to pull down these fuel cutoff levers, which means the engines will go out, and we are on APU power, so that's no problem. We can turn off all the fuel pumps, and we can turn off all the lights, so the anti-collision light can go off, the packs stay on, all these things stay on. You can turn off the electronics over here, the middle two. And for now, you can turn off the seat belts and no smoking, that's no problem. And eventually, you can turn off the APU, because if, let's have a look, is there ground power available? We can go on ground power. And when we are on ground power, you can turn off the APU. We can turn off the IRSs, and we can turn off the battery, which means the aircraft is now successfully landed at Düsseldorf Airport with all passengers on board. Yep, they are going to unload in a second, and we also now made the airplane cold and dark again for the next crew. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Düsseldorf International Airport. We made it. I hope you like this tutorial series of two tutorials. There's another tutorial coming on how to fly on VetSim, So you can use the Zeebo 737, you can not only fly it now, but you can also fly it online. So I hope to see you in the third tutorial. Make sure to like and subscribe to this channel for more content, and I see you next time. See ya!
We lose our sound in the spirit of things. We lose our sight when we put our trust in things of this material world, of things that fade away. Yet we keep coming back, 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 keep coming back.
Smoky, 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 sm